All right, good morning, everybody. I'd like to make a short training video on how to use this soundboard. And I want to do it, we're doing it during their practice up here. So we got some music to listen to and show you how it works here. So first thing first, the power switch is back there. So it's on already. And when you turn the soundboard on first, then the power strip on the stage that has the other equipment with microphones and stuff, and then we turn on the power amps. When you turn it off, first the power amps off, then the equipment on the stage there, and then the board finally. So it's a complicated board and there's a lot of things on it, so I want to try to simplify a little for you in the different sections. So down here we have, and first of all, let me mention, I'm not a sound engineer. I'm new to this, just learned the board a couple months ago myself, so that might be helpful to people that are new with this. So let me turn down the light a little bit. Okay, so turn down the light a little bit. So for this section here is all the controls for the individual instruments. So if you go in close, each button is labeled. So those are the drums. And then over here we have guitar, piano. Okay, so the buttons are labeled. And let's see what we can do to demonstrate something. So then what happens is if you, these buttons on the side allow you to access different sets of instruments. So for example, when I press this button, the sliders change and the labels change. And this one we have labeled as vocal. So now we have the various microphones. We have talk one, vocal three, vocal four, vocal five, vocal six, and Bobby, and Pastor Todd. So, and these two are the main ones we use here, instruments and vocal. So, what we'll try to do is, okay, I'll demonstrate that in a little while here, I think. So, now let me go over on this side. On this side of the board is the main controls, okay? So we have, again, the same thing. We have some buttons here that give us access to different ranges of, or different sets of controls. So on the top one, we have the a playback control right here. And then, let's see, LR is the main volume. So it is turned all the way down right now. And the sound that we hear is just the monitors from the stage, because there's other activities going on nearby during the practice and they don't want to disturb those, but we'll turn it up here shortly just to demonstrate. So, so again, this slider is kind of like the main controls, where the left side of the board is the individual instruments. So the playback would be as if the computer, we're going to play a video or something, and up on the screen, the playback slider shows that volume. And then the, let me just turn this up for a second. So, okay, I guess they're not in the mic. The instruments came up a little bit. There we go. The instruments came up a little bit. Turn back down again for now. So then in that second group of instruments is the monitor. So if the monitor volume up on the stage is too low or too high, then we can use these sliders here to control that that volume. And these, the other ones, are more like groups of instruments. So like the choir there has all the inputs that are designated as choir, so you can get all of them at once. And likewise with talk and orchestra and so forth. So, but normally we don't. I don't touch those. Mainly the ones I would touch is on the first bus here. So if you want to cut down, raise or lower the drums, you can see they're right there on the first one. And then the main ones over here is the playback for the computer and LR for the house. Okay, so I hope that simplifies a little bit, just these sets of functions. And I'll just mention this top left of the board is where you can get the gain and fine-tune things. Basically, I almost never have to touch that. I'm not really familiar with how to do that well yet, so that's a good thing. I don't have to touch that much. So basically, during a service, we only have to touch this row of sliders down here, and then and the main controls over here. That's normally what we do during a service. So let me see if I can demonstrate. So right now we'll switch to vocals. So we get the okay. Then I'm going to bring over the let's bring up the main volume. So. Suddenly we hear that talking there. So now that I can cut down Bobby there. So I just knocked him out with this slider. Now I bring him back up. Okay, so that's, you can also mute him like that. Okay, that cuts out one input. And we could also mute, for example, if we go to the instruments. That's fine. I think the keyboard is right here. We gotta wait for some sound on that. So let's see what else we can say. Okay. There's all the various drums. Okay. Alright, let me talk about something else that's kind of important for the people on the stage. There's a button here that's labeled sends on fader right here. So when we press that allows us to control the input to, for example, just the monitor on the stage. So when I click this, or when I push this button, okay, and then I have to select something. So I'm going to say monitor 2 is Bobby's monitor, the music director there. So now, as soon as we do that, you can see that everything over here changes. I'm going to take it off for a second. Okay, when I take that sends on faders off, then it goes back to the normal sliders, okay? But when I touch that button again, now it's showing all the levels going to his monitor. So because monitor 2 is selected over here, you can see monitor 2 is selected, right? Then now if he says, I want a little more guitar or a little more bass or in the monitor or less keyboard or more keyboard, you can see all these sliders over here are adjusted the way he's asked for them to be adjusted. Because he doesn't want to get overpowered in his monitor with the drums, for example, or certain other instruments. So when somebody asks for a little bit more in the monitor, a little bit less, so monitor 1 is for the choir. They have a separate monitor. So we could select theirs, and you can see their sliders are slightly different over here. So Bobby's monitor is number 2. So as soon as we take off, see this button is flashing to show us that we're just looking at the inputs to that device. So now as we clear that, then it stops flashing, and then we're back to normal settings. Okay, so let's review again here. The instruments are on the first row. So it says instruments, and then vocals are on the second set of sliders. And each one's labeled, maybe not correctly, but we learn what's what. And that's usually all we have to use in a service, is these first two selections of instruments, these first two sets. Okay, so the main volume, of course, over there. Then we got to choose again. There's two sets we use over here, mainly just one during a service, but that top one gives the access to the playback and drums. Normally we don't go into, I don't go into this one much. So, okay, so I hope that's helpful to remove some of the mystery of the board. The solo button here, like for example, this is useful for basically for a sound check. If you plug in some headphones and then press the solo button like that, this means that you'll only hear the sound from that device and the headphones. So you can check all your individual instruments and see what's coming through. If you want to look at the vocal range, then you can go and listen to each person singing individually. If you don't know who's off key or who's on key, you can check it. Just hit solo and then clear it, and that way you can hear each instrument or microphone. This is helpful when balancing things and troubleshooting. So we have some things muted at the moment. This microphone up here was giving us a little trouble, a little noise, so it's muted. That's the red, you can see it's muted there. And then the other thing to be very important, I guess, over here is the mute groups over here. So right now we just have this paper here corresponds to a set of six buttons here. So you can see that the bottom one is on right now is the lobby and recording channel. So because we're in practice, the lobby is muted. So when we're ready to start the service, then or getting close to that time, we'll unmute that, and then whatever music is going will go out to the lobby also. So let's start with this one, the effects at the top. So the microphones are set up right now with various functions, modifications that's good for singing. Maybe some reverb and other settings, which I'm not even familiar with all of them. But if someone's going to use one of those microphones to talk, what we want to do is mute number two. So as soon as we do that, then it takes out all the extra stuff, and then it's real clear for talking. So that's good to know. Now, so if we want to mute just the choir, we can press number four here. That's right, that corresponds this for the choir. So we'll just hit that one, and that would mute the choir in the output and the main house speakers. During the sermon, there's this set of, we can just click on sermon, or push on sermon, and that, let's do it over here, so that mutes all the drums and most of the instruments. And if we wanted to mute the monitors, and really, let's try this, this might get their attention. Yep. That just cut out the music for a moment. So that cut out the only sound. So, but sometimes when during the sermon, it seems to make it a little bit clearer if we cut out the monitors in the back there. So we have the control just over the monitors. All right. So of course you can hit all. Hit all and monitors, lobby, effects, choir, and then the sermon. So hopefully that's helpful for explaining the various mute functions. Okay, wish you well with learning the board. It's probably not as hard as it seems. It's quite intimidating. The good thing is that the stuff here on the right, you mostly don't have to touch that. I don't even know what it all does. Now there is something more, and again, this section of the top left, we can leave that one alone mostly. It's mainly this section and this section we use. One more thing that's useful, if you want to talk to them, there's a microphone that's hooked up to the board, so we can activate talk A and talk B, and one goes to the monitors, I think, and the other to the house speakers, and we can adjust our volume, how loud we want to talk to everybody with the talk level, and then we can talk in the microphone there. I won't do that now, so. And then we want to turn it off just to hit those two buttons off. So that's when you're talking to the choir director, trying to work things out. And here we've got a microphone over here. Okay, one more thing here. So this display has a lot of information. You don't really need to use too much of it. Maybe I'll talk about this saving a little bit later. But basically, when you want to save it, just go to the view button over here. So it goes from monitoring the sound quality and so forth to just there's your various waveforms. And now you can save and recall programs in your stored settings. Okay, so service is over, and everything's on mute now. Everything's off already. I just wanted to show you how to save the program. What I like to do is save it with everything not muted, in case I have to recall a program in the middle of a performance, which I have done that, actually. So, so let's just unmute things here. You're not going to hear anything because there's no input. And all right, and put the sound back up to the normal level here. Okay, and I think everything else is okay. Instruments, vocals, everything should be good there. And okay, so the only thing really that has to be changed is the playback if we were to recall that. So now we'll go up here to, first we'll push on the view button. So the view is right here. When I press that, then you're going to see it change to the display where it shows the various settings, configurations, settings saved. Okay, so we've been using scene 20, and so I'm going to come down here and just press this to save. And once we do that, so it gives you a chance, you can rename it. So you have, for example, backspace. You just push the backspace and then watch the cursor move. Okay. So then we'll just go over here. Then when you want to set your character, you choose your character set with this. Okay, turn the knob here. Turn this one. And then I can go replace that Y I just erased with this set. Okay. EQ. Not sure what I erased anyway. So I'll just backspace again. It should be, okay, it should be. All right, we'll put in R, Y, okay. And save. And then it asks you, do you want to replace it? And then we do want to override it. So then we go down here and use this. That's the yes down here. So we say yes over here. And then now it's saved. Now we can go up here and we can see. Okay. Now this gray cursor here, it shows where you're going to go. Actually save the same thing on 25. So I'm going to save it as a backup. So I'm going to go save. Okay, and then we go save again, and then yes, we want our places. So yes is on the right side, and we come over here and say yes. So now we have a program saved in two places. Now if we wanted to load a program, we just use the gray select, and then just say go. Push this button knob down, load scene 20, and we say yes. Over here, same confirmation. So yes on the right side, and we load that there. And there it goes. So now we're back on, the orange is on 20. And you can also plug in a USB flash drive right here. And you can go to this one over here, save the settings to the USB drive right here. And it's right there, save it to this USB drive. And I won't demonstrate that now, but you can figure that out. Just save it and it should, maybe it'll give you confirmation. And that's that. So now we want to go back to, so the view takes us from one display to the other. And then we'll leave it like that. Okay, this concludes our training for this board. And for now, maybe we'll do some more advanced topics later on. And maybe. And that concludes it for now. So all the best. Remember, it's not too complicated, and just try to get the general concept and go with it. All right.